You know, a smaller home means a smaller footprint on the earth. But what if your tiny dwelling was on wheels as well?
We are south of Fredericksburg on a farm in a beautiful countryside. We came from a 5-bedroom house. We wanted to simplify our lives, so we chose RV living.
But Kathy's one problem is cooking for herself and her husband, John.
I have a lot of cooking challenges. I have the 3-burner stove with the small oven, limited amount of propane, limited amount of water, sometimes limited amount of electricity. I need help. I'm going to show you this RV right here.
Okay.
There you go.
Oh, wow. That's a beauty.
Yeah. It's my home.
That's your home. All right, so here we are.
Let's go see it. My kitchen.
Wow. All right, so 3 burners.
3 burners.
And it's run by propane.
Run by propane.
Now, there's a problem, right, with the burners, right? Correct me if I'm wrong, because you probably have 2 tanks.
Right.
So you have to monitor that.
And we also use it for our heat and can use it for our hot water.
So you really got to monitor it.
Yes.
You have limited water, too, right?
Yes.
About 65 gallons of fresh water.
So, and then a tank that goes into.
Right.
So we have to be even more efficient about cleaning.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly.
Unless you want to waste a bunch of water.
Which I don't want to waste it.
Right.
Pots refrigerator's small, too.
Wow.
A small refrigerator.
All right.
A small freezer. There's my normal dinners.
Okay. I think the way to go, based on what I'm seeing here, is to do a lot of one-pot cooking, which we do a lot of in Louisiana.
Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah. That's great.
So we need to go shopping.
Yes.
And let's go see how we can figure this out.